It's Tuesday here at CES, and Kazuo Hirai, CEO of Sony, kicked off proceedings with a keynote in which he highlighted the importance of delivering products which wow consumers.
The Sony Xperia Z1 harnesses the power of the One Sony ethos. All of the Sony company's deep expertise and knowledge combined to make a mobile device that is truly the best of Sony and something that only Sony can deliver. The elegance of the package belies the robust technological capability within, making the Z1 a distinctly Sony design.
Spectrum challenges and data capacity were familiar themes at a keynote panel this morning. However, wearables also created a buzz, with Qualcomm CEO Paul Jacobs revealing the company is trialing a technology which can detect imminent heart attacks. Also on the panel were AT&T's John Donovan and Ericsson's Hans Vestberg.
We're doing a clinical trial in San Diego of a sensor that will actually get injected into your bloodstream and tell you 2 weeks ahead of time that you're going to have a heart attack. So imagine something like that. I mean, you want to get that phone call because they can help you before you have the heart attack and your heart muscle dies. That's actually a good phone call to get, believe it or not. But that kind of stuff's going to happen. So wearables will not just be on our bodies and in the environment and so forth. They're going to be inside our bodies.
2009 or 10, I believe, we came out with a vision of 50 billion connected devices 2020, and everybody was asking us, I mean, how did you count? And there was a lot of discussion. I mean, now I don't think anybody is even doubting it's going to be 50 billion connected devices.
There's the Terminator model and the Superman model. And I think what we're after is Iron Man, which is to take a mere mortal and provide them all of these other things that gives them superpowers, but the ability to open it up and walk away and be human for a day.
In a keynote very much tailored for a North American audience, Marissa Mayer, CEO of Yahoo, introduced cameos from some familiar faces.
Hi.
Thank you, Marissa Mayer, CEO of Yahoo, for having me.
Come to sun, I stay. It's all right.
She also highlighted the importance of mobile to the company and announced an acquisition and a new launch in this market.
We're incredibly excited to kick things off today by announcing that we've acquired Aviate. As we look to the future of mobile, we believe home screens should be smarter and more personalized. Imagine that your phone could deliver the right experience to you at the right time instead of you having to search for it.
Yahoo New Digest, our new product, provides you with two daily summaries, or digests, one in the morning and one in the evening. They both contain all the important news. The stories are algorithmically produced but editorially curated, demonstrating the perfect blend between technology and journalism.
On the sidelines of the show, Sprint held an event to discuss its network modernization efforts, including its LTE rollout.
Clearly, we've had some challenges with the upgrade that we've done with Network Vision. Sort of the part in our dust, and we're still working through that. But we're going to be substantially complete very quickly on that. You know, we already have 300 cities up and running with LTE today. By mid-year, we're going to have 250 million pops. By the end of this year, we're going to have, you know, sort of 100 million covered with 2.5. So this is the year that we're going to really be able to come back. And that's sort of what I would say is our, you know, part of our theme this year is sort of we're back in the game.
Rounding off proceedings was a keynote from John Chambers, CEO of Cisco.
I want you to think about as you leave, how do you take many of the technology concepts that are being talked about in this conference, such as the Internet of Everything, cloud, mobility, big data, how it changes lives, and think what is next. And think again, not how fast has it moved in the last year, but how fast has it moved since we did the first hosting of the Internet of Things Global Forum in Barcelona just in October this year. And when you think what will be the topic for this time next year, I can tell you already what it's going to be. It's going to be about digital countries, the ability of a country to completely transform itself.
So that wraps up our highlights from today. We'll be back with more tomorrow. I'm Steve Costello for Mobile World Life.